Hello and welcome to the session of biochemistry. This is Suresh Kumar Paswan, assistant professor in GSITS Indore. Today we are going to discuss metabolism of amino acid. So when we are talking about amino acid, the first thing comes into the picture is protein. So what do you think about protein? Like when we talk about protein, if in our body structure, the muscles, these are made up of protein. And when we talk about the dietary source, eggs are there, beef, mutton is there, then pulses are there. These are the source of protein. So when we talk about protein, if we go in the structural part, so we have certain helical structure here. Here we are having this helical structure. And it may be linked by disulfide linkages, and that will form specific tissues. So these helical structure or these protein, these are made up of small building blocks. These are amino acids. These small parts, these are amino acids. And if we stretch it out, we have these amino acids. And like these are the small building blocks of a protein. These are amino acids. When we talk about amino acid, what is amino acids? Like in our human body, nearly about 20 types of amino acids are present. I'm not going to go deep inside that. These are like arginine, histidine, lysine, glutamine, alanine. These are all the structures. So when we talk about amino acid, what is the amino acid? This amino acid, it consists of four parts. Like the main part is one amino group should be there, and the second one is carbon base, and the third one, that is very important, one is amino group and another one is acid group should be there, and one R is a side chain. So all these amino acids, they will have this structure, and the side chain may vary. So one amino group and one acidic group will be there. So talking about protein, or nearly about 100 gram of protein is always there in our body, in body amino acid pool, and nearly about 10 to 12 kilograms of proteins are there in our human adult. So these protein are made up of these protein are of static and dynamic kind of structure. Static structure are like your muscles, and your dynamic structures are like your hormones, enzymes. These are the dynamic structure. So nearly about 300 to 400 grams of protein is daily broken down into amino acid, and the same way the synthesis of protein will be done in the same manner. So nearly about 300 to 400 gram of protein amino acid will be required. So from the dietary source, nearly about 100 gram of protein, from 40 to 100 gram of protein is required, and again in synthesis of non-essential amino acid, and from non-essential amino acid to amino acid pool, that will be done vice versa. And here from amino acid pool, thus in the case of synthesis of non-protein compounds like creatinine, olefin, phospholipids, purines, pyrimidines, these are all made by this amino acid pool. Likewise, again, these amino acid will contribute in the synthesis of carbohydrates, fats, and in production of energy. Nearly about 10 to 15% of body energy requirement is being covered by amino acid, but it is not the main source. Main source is your glucose. And the excretion of protein loss will be there in the form of urea in urine, nearly about 40 to 30 to 50 grams. In metabolism of amino acid, two parts are very important. One is transamination, another one is deamination. So when we talk about transamination, we have this amino group in amino acid, and another one is keto group in a ketoacidic structure. So what will happen, this pyridoxal phosphate, this is a coenzyme, and transaminase is the main enzyme. What they will do, they will exchange these particular groups. So here what will happen, this amino acid, it will be exchanged into this keto acidic group and this keto group will be exchanged, and here what happens, like exchange of this particular groups takes place, and here the amino group is not been removed. Okay, here the main thing is we are exchanging the groups. Likewise, here we have an alanine amino acid and one keto glutarate is another structure. So here what has happened, this particular group and this particular amino group is being exchanged by this pyridoxal phosphate. So this is very important coenzyme that will exchange this particular groups, this amino and keto groups. So here we are getting pyruvate, and from keto glutarate we are getting glutamate. So glutamate, it will have this amino group. So what happens, like this reaction, this reaction is reversible reaction, so vice versa it will take, it may take place. And talking about deamination is removal of amino group. So from that glutamate what we have got, so this glutamate, it will enter into liver, and from the liver it will enter into the mitochondria, and it will dissociate into alpha keto glutarate, again the same thing, and what it will do, it will remove this amino group. And likewise, when it will again here amino transferase group is there, aspartate amino transferase, what it will do, it will combine with oxaloacetate and it will transfer its amino group to form aspartate, and again here keto glutarate will form. So in both case this amino group has been removed, and what will happen, this amino group again it has certain role, we'll discuss later on. So this amino group in the combination of this carboxylic group and in the presence of 2 ATP has been consumed here, and it will form carbamyl phosphate in presence of carbamyl phosphate synthase. And this ornithine, another one, it will enter into urea cycle, and ornithine is there, ornithine in presence of ornithine transcarbamylase, it will combine with carbamylase and it will form citrulline. Citrulline is an important compound. It may come out from the mitochondria to proceed the further step, and here from this particular portion it will combine with aspartate and it will form arginosuccinate in the presence of arginosuccinate synthase. So why this aspartate is important for us, because here it is contribute this amino group. An amino group, it has been contributed from this aspartate, and this arginoacetate, it will convert into arginine and fumarate in the presence of arginosuccinate. So this succinate enzyme, it is very important. Like here we are getting fumarate. So fumarate, what is happening, fumarate, it will again, it's a part of TCA cycle and it's a source of energy. So this fumarate, it will go into TCA cycle and may convert into glucose even by gluconeogenesis pathway. And the second compound, which is arginine, it will, in the presence of arginase enzyme, it will form ornithine and it will liberate urea. So urea is our main compound. So here we are having two amino group in urea. One amino group we are getting from this glutamate here, and another we are getting from aspartate. So this amino, urea, it will be removed by urine. So next is talking about formation of ammonia that we have seen in the process of deamination, and the transport of transport and storage of ammonia. Ammonia is a very toxic compound present in our body. It comes from glutamate, and this amino group, it may combine with glutamate and it will form glutamine, or it will go through the certain chain and it will form alanine. And this glutamine and alanine, it goes to the brain, and in the brain, if their concentration is high, like this ammonia, it will be converting into glutamine. And this glutamine, if its concentration is high in the brain, so what will happen, it will attract water inside. Okay, this H2O, it will be attracted inside the water, and cerebral edema may take place. So certain compounds like benzoate is there, phenyl butyrate, phenyl acetate is there. So those compound, may be given to remove this glutamate. They will react with this compound like sodium benzoate. They will react with the glutamine and they will form water soluble compound and they can be excreted from the urine. Okay. So next is the function of ammonia. Like it may also help in the synthesis of amino acid, purine, pyrimidine, amino structure and aspargine, etc. Toxicity of ammonia we already discussed, like it's a very toxic compound. Next is elevation of blood urea. So whatever the urea it has been found over there, so that is also very problematic. Like if it is excreted from the urine, then it's well and nice. But if it is not excreted from the urine, so what may be the case? So there is three type of conditions we are getting, like pre-renal, renal and post-renal. In pre-renal, like major, when there is a major surgery, if it is there, and if there is a prolonged fever, diabetic coma, thyrotoxicosis, and in the case of leukemia also, this pre-renal protein may increase in our body. And the second one is renal disorders are there, like if you have a chronic glomerular nephritis is there, chronic nephritis, nephrosclerosis is there, in that case this blood urea will not be excreted. So this is another disorder. And the post-renal, like if there is obstruction in the urinary tract, if you have a tumor in the urinary tract, if you have a stone in your urinary tract, and if you have a enlarged prostate in your urinary tract, enlarged prostate, so in that case the urea cannot be excreted in our body and it will lead to certain complications. So talking about the catabolism of certain amino acid, like we have 20 amino acid and most of the amino acid has been catabolized in our body, and here you can see like it goes into the TCA cycle or citric acid cycle. Here like alanine, citrine, cysteine, serine, glycine, threonine, tryptophan, it converts into pyruvate and it goes to oxaloacetate. Likewise here acetoacetyl-CoA, acetyl-CoA can be converted from leucine, lysine, and this may also, it may go to beta oxidation, and here these compound may go to, they may form pyruvate and they can get inside the citric acid cycle, or it may go to form energy in the case of they may be converted into glucose 6-phosphate, and from there it may convert to glucose. Likewise here phenyl triosine, isoleucine, methionine, it may these may convert to fumarate and succinyl-CoA, and arginine, glutamine, histidine, proline, it may convert to glutamate, and from the glutamate it may convert to alpha-ketoglutarate. So these are the things I have got from Principle of Biochemistry by Leninger's, Biochemistry by Satyanarayana and Chakrapani. I hope you people have enjoyed my videos, and I think like I have made some sense, I have given, contributed something to you peoples. If you have any query, you can write to me or you can call me, okay, my mobile number is there. So thank you very much. I hope you will be suffering from lockdown period. But anyway, stay there, stay safe, stay healthy in your house. Thank you very much.